Oh no. Oh, what a bummer. And there's no way to go down in one of those. It's gonna be so cold for her.
So good morning, everyone. So I'm filming a little bit of a belated intro today as we had quite a big ride yesterday and got home quite late. So yesterday we ended up doing an adventure ride to Yerranderie, which is an old silver mining ghost town about 300 kilometers out of Sydney. It is actually quite a popular and famous adventure ride, so we thought we might as well give it a go while we're down in this direction. And it was absolutely fabulous. We had such an amazing day. It was in total about 230 kilometers and we're on the bikes for about 7 hours or so quite a hefty day. But overall it was amazing, but as we got home so late, not everything went to plan. But it was some amazing trails and I really do hope you enjoy the video, and make sure you leave a like and subscribe if you did. Leaving our home base now and starting our big ride for the day. So the plan is to head to a little ghost mining town called Yerranderie, and Dad said it was about maybe 105 kilometers away from where we are now, but we actually don't have too much of a clue. We're kind of just winging it at this point, but it is an absolutely amazing day. The weather is beautiful and it's actually not too cold. It's only about 12 degrees now, but that sun's making it quite warm, which is very lucky because we were planning for a cold one this morning. But it should be a really good day of riding. We're very excited. Go down the mountain here and we've hit the fog really bad. You can't really see that far in front of you now. I'm just kind of following Dad's tail light and hoping there's not a big truck coming the other way, basically. So we finally reached the river and have gotten out of the fog. So we can see kind of. That was foggy. So in order to get to Yerranderie, we actually have to go through the Wombeyan Caves roads again. So we're about 15 kilometers away from the Wombeyan Caves now. And so we'll probably have to go back up through the cloud of fog that we just came through before. But me and Mum absolutely love this road, so it's definitely no inconvenience to go through it again. Climbing the hill on the other side of the river. And we haven't hit the major fog yet. But this road is so much fun. It's just a little bit more technical than a normal dirt road where you can just kind of play around the corners. God, it's just so spooky in here with all the trees.
It's strange. I thought the sun would actually clear it out a lot faster than it has, because it's about 10 or 11 o'clock now. I haven't checked the time.
So we finally come out of the fog and now we can finally see the sunshine again. What an amazing day. We are so, so lucky that the weather has drastically improved in the last week. Alrighty, so we're just about 4 kilometers out from Wombeyan Caves now, but instead we're going to end up taking a right just on, I think it's called Lang's Road here, just to cut out the caves and hopefully save a little bit of distance. But so far it's been absolutely awesome and we've actually come out to some pretty good weather. We're a little bit worried going through some of that fog though. It looked a bit dark and cold, but it's definitely brightened up a lot and hopefully we stay on track. So we've just turned around. And because Dad saw on his maps on his phone that there's a little cut through fire trail that's only meant to be about 9 kilometers long, whereas the other road we're planning to take was about 20k long. So he's hoping this goes through, which on the map it says it does. But wow, the tracks in here are so stunning. But anyway, it's all a part of the adventure. Mum says it's better to take the shorter route just in case we run out of fuel. Because her bike isn't as fuel efficient as ours, we've found. This road's definitely wetter than anything we've done so far today. So fingers crossed this fire trail actually comes out where we are wanting it to, but you never know unless you try. We've only done about 41 kilometers so far today, so we haven't made too much ground. So we kind of got to keep getting a move on. Because we don't want another late night like we had last time. Apparently we've only got about 3 more K on this fire trail here before we turn onto another fire trail. But these fire trails are just awesome. Mum's absolutely flying. I'm struggling to keep up with her. They've actually been pretty wet, surprisingly, seeing we're on top of the hill, but it hasn't been too slippery, which has been good. We actually wanted to take now had a gate over it, so we're just taking a little different fire trail, which apparently is now 11 k's to the actual road, and it's not as shortcutty as we wanted it to be, but it still is meant to take out a major chunk of the original route, only if there's not a gate at the other end. But that's the question. That's a promising sign, actually. It's not too often you see bike riders out here. So hopefully that means the gate is open at the other end. It means this distance was not for nothing.
Luckily they did have electric bikes though, because going up some of these hills would be quite an effort. We actually went for a ride the other morning on our mountain bikes, and me and Mum have the push bikes only and Dad's got the electric, and some of those hills on the way back were just so painful and Dad was just flying past us. So we are quite jealous. Wow, it's just so cool out here. Oh no! Oh, straight into the puddle. That's always the way. It's actually been pretty good with Mum in front of me, so I can kind of gauge where the big puddles of water have been. So we're 57 kilometers into our trip so far today, and it has been an amazing ride so far. Oh, that was a deep one. Oh no! That's what I mean with Mum in front, I can kind of gauge the depth and if there's actually a puddle there or not. We've been going downhill for ages though, and we're still pretty high up. These hills are actually quite steep, it probably won't show it on the camera, but they've got quite a bit of a steepness to them. There are some quite steep hills going on out here though. Not the correct gear, there we go. Sorry Dad, I'm cutting you off over there. I'm trying to practice standing up a bit more today, which I'm slowly getting there, but I'm not as consistent as I would like to be, but I'm always still learning new things. I love every minute of this ride. It's just so cool, all the different sceneries you go through, all the different trees and going through the hills. It's just so cool. Oh, big splash for Mum. Looks like a little bit of water up ahead. I think we can get around the side there. Whoop. Wouldn't want to be getting too wet today because it's actually quite chilly. This looks promising. It looks like we're coming out to a bit more of a main road, which is really cool. How good are you riding?
I love that.
That's so fun, isn't it?
Well, because it's a little bit technical, but not where I get anxiety, and it's just fun.
I'm absolutely loving it.
That's good, eh?
That was awesome.
Huh?
So good.
That's nice.
Alrighty, so we just turned onto Kalongstock Road, and apparently this almost goes all the way through to Yerranderie. But that fire trail cut through that we just did was so good. Absolutely loved it. And it's not often that we get such good luck where the cut through we test out actually works. Apparently Dad talked to some of those bike riders that were going past, and all of them had electric bikes except for one. And some of those hills, I'm like, that would have been such a struggle. They were very, very steep. I'm so glad we ended up coming back out here to the farm just to get some of this good weather, because we didn't get the full experience before. Like, the rides we did before were so much fun, but we weren't going to be able to do this ride because it was just too wet. So I'm so glad we made the effort to come back out, because today has been so worth it. We just worked out that Dad left his backpack at home, which contained the drone and his lunch. So he might be going a little bit hungry at Yerranderie. But luckily we looked back at photos and he must have left it at home, back at the farm, and not just left it down somewhere where we stopped for a drink break or something. Because that would not have been good trying to backtrack and find a backpack. So we should only be about 25 to 30 kilometers away now. So we're 89 kilometers in so far. We've been traveling for almost 3 hours.